Okay, to continue where I ended, I did not know that I was disconnected already. So this is the generalization or the findings from Arrhenius equation based on the behavior of that particular line representing the relationship between ln of k and the reciprocal of the temperature. So number one, if you're going to have a plot of ln of k versus 1 over t, from Arrhenius' law, it gives a straight line with a large slope for large e and a small slope for small e. I think you have seen it already that the, and I have mentioned it also, that you will have a large slope for this line for high activation energy. Otherwise, it will have a small slope. Reactions with high activation energies are very temperature sensitive, and reactions with low activation energy are relatively temperature insensitive due to the very, small value in the manner in which the slope of the line decreases if you have a low activation energy. And it could be translated to the degree of dependency of the rate of reaction with respect to temperature. So the higher the activation energy, the reaction is very temperature sensitive. The lower the activation energy is relatively insensitive already. So meaning it does not affect anymore the reaction rate. At any given reaction or any given reaction for that matter, it is much more temperature sensitive at low temperature than at high temperature. So low temperature reactions are more temperature sensitive than high temperature reactions. So these are the things that you will be able to get from Arrhenius. Aside from that, the value of the frequency factor K sub O, that's the same constant that appears or that has the same set of units as the K, does not affect the temperature sensitivity of a reaction. Why? Because as I have mentioned already, this frequency factor is a constant, so it's not whatsoever affected by changes in the temperature. So these are the things that we can deduce from the relationship of ln of k and 1 over t, or we can take from that is from the Arrhenius equation. Now you have a sample problem here, and this will use the formula or the ratio that I have asked you the relationships a while ago of. So in the first, it is a given, it's a general rule of thumb that a rate of reaction or the rate of reaction is doubled for every 10 degree rise in temperature. You are requested here, or you are asked to develop a relationship between the temperature and the activation.